Hello students, very good morning to all of you. Welcome to Unacademy MSET YouTube channel. Myself Vaishali Karmanthi, chemistry educator of Unacademy. Am I audible to all of you? Hi Prince Pritam, very good morning. I had 13 years of teaching experience. In MSET AAAA NEET and mains levels, and this is my code for taking of this plus subscription courses. Am I audible to all of you guys? Respond once in chat section. Welcome to Unacademy MSET YouTube channel. Okay, thank you, Pritam. This is about the plus subscription course introduced by the Unacademy for the 2021 aspirants who are writing MSET in 2021. And this is the batches are running from October 12th. So, Unacademy introducing the plus 12 months plan will be 12,375. 6 months plan will be 10,125. And the trial pack will be introduced. That will be the price of the 2,250 rupees. 1 month trial pack. And this is the Telugu batch TS and AP MSET 2021. And learn from the best educators for the MSET 2021. And detailed explanation will be given in the Telugu medium for the better understanding the concepts. Complete syllabus coverage will be there, and this batches will be going to start on October 12th. So enroll now for the subscription students, and by using of the code Vaishali Live, you will get the 10% of discount. And what are the advantages of by taking of this plus courses? By taking this plus subscription course, premium content at the affordable price. Second one is there will be structured live courses, dedicated live doubt clearing session. That means for every completion of the two hours, there will be a direct interaction with the top educators in the live session to clear your doubts. And third one is visits at the regular intervals for the self-analysis for every completion of one course. Batches for complete preparation, that is of the 8 months complete syllabus plan. And next one is 6 months course completion. And by taking of the single subscription, you can get the unlimited access to watch all the videos of all the subjects like maths, physics and chemistry for any educator. So everything under the single plus subscription is possible by taking of this single subscription. Use the code Vaishali Live and you will get 10% discount instant. Discussing about the second shift paper part 2. In the first part we discussed about the 20 questions. We will discuss today remaining 20 questions. Hi Kittu, very good morning. Hi Ashwathama. For differentiating of the intensive and the extensive properties, intensive here we are taking the, for example here I am taking two rooms here, yes, so this is the partition here, and whenever here pressure, volume, temperature and the concentration, concentration equal to number of moles, concentration equal to number of moles for the volume in liter, so whenever number of moles decreasing, the concentration will be changing, so depends upon the mass. So that will be the extensive. Is it clear? Today we will discuss the 21st question. Yeah. Yes, look at this. What will be the product A in the reaction given below? Anything treated with the nitrous acid in the presence of the acidic medium, that will give you the A here. And find out the A here. Aniline reacts with the nitrous acid in the presence of the HCl. What is the product here? First one is phenol, second one is benzene diazonium salts, and third one is benzene, and the fourth one is nitrobenzene. Any guess? For the complete syllabus coverage of the 8 months and the 6 months, Unacademy introduced the plus courses. So in my plus courses, already I am discussing about the noble gases. Second one is nitrogen containing compounds from the organic chemistry and from the physical chemistry, chemical kinetics and physical chemistry. I am discussing about the solid state in the whole month. The four courses are published in the plus courses of mine. And in the evening session, I will discuss at 7 p.m. today in the special class, that is complete tricks and tips of noble gases. Noble gases. Come and join the sessions at 7 o'clock in the evening. Look at this. Aniline treated with nitrous acid in the presence of acidic medium, so that they will form benzene diazonium salts, that is of N2 plus and the Cl minus, along with water molecule. Hi Kumar, very good morning. Option B is the right one. Ashwadama, good. Yes. Next one. Look at this. Arrange the following carbocations in the increasing order of their stability with respect to the labels. Look at the table is given. In this case, here this will be the secondary carbocation and this will be the methyl carbocation. Methyl carbocation, and this is the tertiary carbocation, and this is the primary carbocation. We already know that stability of the carbocations is of the order tertiary is greater than, secondary is greater than, primary is greater than methyl carbocation. Why? Because look at this. In this case of tertiary, here I am taking this one CH3 plus. So stability of the carbocations. Stability of the carbocations depends upon plus I groups. Directly depends upon the plus I groups. Whenever plus I group is present, the stability of the carbocations increases. Because of the dispersal of the positive charge, the stability will be increased. In the case of the tertiary carbocations, 3 methyl groups are present. 3 methyl groups are the positive inductive effect groups, that is electron releasing groups. Can we say that electron releasing groups are plus I groups? Generally plus I groups increases the stability of the carbocation. So tertiary is more stable than that of secondary, than that of primary, and than that of the methyl carbocation. So now what is the order here for the stability? For the stability, increasing order we have to write here. Look at this. Second 2 is less stable than that of fourth one, and next one is 1, next one is 3. So this is the order of the stability of the carbocations. That means tertiary is more stable than that of the secondary, than primary, than methyl carbocation. Is it clear now? Preetam, any doubt? Next question. Free expansion of an ideal gas, which So you won't miss any single class. Look at this. For an isothermal and free expansion of an ideal gas. Isothermal means at a constant temperature, del T equal to 0 here. Yes? This is for the AP. This paper is AP I am discussing here. And the whole classes will be for both TS and AP. Already the classes are going to start from 12th October. Full syllabus coverage. Look at this. For an isothermal and free expansion, for an isothermal del T equal to 0, we already know that del U equal to Q plus W. Q plus W. W equal to work done. Then Q equal to P external into del V. Here we are taking that work done at the isophoric process. Isochoric process del V equal to 0. Then del U equal to Q. For an free expansion, we are taking this Q equal to 0. This is for the adiabatic change. For an adiabatic change, heat is taken as the 0 here. Thank you. Next question. Which oxide among the following cannot act as a reducing agent? Cannot act as a reducing agent. Very good morning, Sanjita. Join the session. Which oxide among the following cannot act as a reducing agent? First, we have to understand what is the definition of the reducing agent. Reducing agent means any atom which loses the electrons. That can act as a reducing agent. In the case of sulfur dioxide, sulfur is possess the oxidation state of plus 4. Sulfur can exhibit plus 6 oxidation state by the loss of the 2 electrons. So, this will be act as a reducing agent. Whenever in the case of NO2, nitrogen is exhibiting the plus 4 oxidation state, it can change to plus 5 oxidation state by the loss of 1 electron. Yes? So, it will act as a reducing agent. And coming to the CO2, carbon dioxide, carbon possesses the plus 4 oxidation state. Carbon exhibit only the plus 4 oxidation state only. Both AP and TS. Syllabus coverage. In the case of carbon dioxide, carbon possesses the plus 4 oxidation state. There is no loss of electron and there is no gain of electron. So this will does not act as a reducing agent. In coming to the ClO2, in the case of chlorine, it possesses plus 4 oxidation state. This can expand its oxidation state by loss of 3 electrons. So chlorine can form plus 7 oxidation state also by loss of the 3 electrons. Yes? So this will act as a reducing agent. So reducing agent means whenever any atom loses the electrons, so that it will act as a reducing agent. Yes, from 12th onwards. Which one? For nitrogen. Nitrogen can exhibit plus 4 maximum to plus 5 oxidation state. Nitrogen can exhibit plus 5 oxidation state. So nitrogen plus 4 to plus 5 oxidation state changes by the loss of electrons. So it can act as a reducing agent. But in this case, carbon possesses only the plus 4 oxidation state. So it cannot act as an oxidizing agent. Yes, for all the subjects. So correct option will be the CO2 does not act as a reducing agent. Next one. Look at this. Rate of reaction HCA plus YB gives rise to ZC is given by, rate of the reaction is given as K into concentration of A power X into B power Y. If the concentration of A is tripled, rate of the reaction is increased by 27 times over the initial. Vaishali Live. My code is Vaishali Live. So that you will get 10% discount. Look at this. Here, given equation as xA plus yB gives rise to zC. Rate of the reaction is written as R equal to K into initial concentration of A power X. The coefficient is raised to the power A power X into B power Y. So here I am taking this one as the first equation. Now look at this. Hi Johnny, join the session. Look at this. Whenever the initial concentration A is tripled, that means the rate of the reaction is increased by 27 times. Look at this. Whenever initial concentration is tripled, the rate of the reaction changes to 27 times of the rate of the reaction. Then K into 3 power A power X into B power Y. So this is the second equation, right? We will try to guide you in a better way, Johnny. Hi Sumasri. Look at this. 2 by 1, that indicates that 27 R by R equal to K into 3 A power X into concentration of B power Y by, look at this, K into A power X into B power Y. So cancel the common terms, then you will get 27 equal to 3 power X. So look at this, 3 cube equal to 3 power X. Then X equal to 3 here, X equal to 3. Then substitute the value here, substitute the value so that R equal to K into 3 A power X. 3 A power X. So here order of the reaction is, order of the reaction is 3. Then here the question is, we are drawing a graph between half life on the y axis and initial concentration on the x axis. Then you will get a graph is like this. This is the first order, this is the first order, and this is the zero order, and this is the second order. So here look at this, the graph will be this one, T half versus initial concentration. So we will look at the options, which one is the correct one. Yes, this is the correct option. Second one is the correct option here. One second. So we are taking half life on the y axis and initial concentration on the x axis. Any doubt in this? Next question. Which of the following compound will exhibit the cis trans isomerism? Any guess? Which of the following compound will exhibit cis trans isomerism? Here given options are the 2-butene. Write the structures of the compounds. 2-butene. Look at this. 2-butene means double bond at the second carbon atom. So place CH3, CH, CH and CH3. Now second one is 2-butyne. So CH3, here it is CH3, and 2-butanol, CH3 CH2, and here it is CH CH3. And coming to the butanol, so for exhibiting of the cis trans isomerism, what are the conditions for any compound will show the cis trans isomerism? That means cis trans isomerism is shown in the geometrical isomerism when the geometrical isomerism is shown in the doubly bonded carbon atoms. So look at this, in this case of C double bond C, here I am writing this one as H and CH3. Here it is hydrogen and CH3. Each carbon atom should possess the two different groups, but not of the same groups. So look at this, here hydrogen and hydrogen are on the same side. This will be of the cis isomerism. Whenever here I am changing the groups here, this will be CH3 and here I am placing CH3 here, hydrogen, hydrogen. Look at the groups, hydrogen and hydrogen in the opposite direction. So this will be considered as the trans isomerism. Is it clear now? Any compound which will exhibit the geometrical isomerism, then there should be a doubly bonded carbon atom and each carbon atom should possess the two different groups. Then only that compound will show the cis-trans isomerism. So the correct option is the 2-butane will show the cis-trans isomerism. Next question. Preetam, are you there? Next question. Further reaction NO2 plus CO is in equilibrium with NO and CO2. 1 mole of NO2 and 2 moles of CO were kept in the vessel. Calculate the equilibrium constant Kp. If at equilibrium 25% of initial amount of CO is consumed. Look at this. Given equation as NO2 plus CO, it is in equilibrium with NO plus CO. We have to find out Kp. Kp equal to Kc into RT power del Ng. Del Ng. Here look at this. Del Ng equal to number of gaseous products, that is of the 2 minus of 2 equal to 0. Then Kp value equal to Kc. So first find out the Kc values here so that you will get the Kp value. Look at this. Here initial they are giving as 1 mole of NO2. NO2 plus CO, which is in equilibrium with NO plus CO. Initial 1 mole of NO2 and 2 moles of CO2. And this will give you the 0 and 0. At equilibrium, 25% of CO is consumed. 25% of CO is consumed means 25% of the 2 moles. That is equal to 25 by 100 into 2. That is equal to 1 by 2. That means 1 mole of NO2 react with the 1 mole of CO so that they can form 1 mole and 1 mole. That means whenever you are taking the 2 moles of CO, it is 25% is consumed. That means that indicates that half. Half indicates that in the 2 moles, half is 1. So we are writing the equilibrium constant Kc value equal to, Kc value equal to, here look at this, concentration of NO into concentration of CO by concentration of NO2 into concentration of CO. So look at this, half into half by half into 3 by 2. That is equal to 1/3, which is equal to 0.33. So Kc value equal to, we obtained the value of Kc equal to 1/3. From this Kc value, Kp equal to 1/3. So we will look at the option. Yes, the correct option will be the 1/3. Next question. Which among the following statements is true about the reactivity of the halogens, haloarenes towards the nucleophilic substitution reactions? Any guess? First option is haloarenes are very reactive towards nucleophilic substitution reactions. Second option is in haloarenes, the CX bond requires partial double bond character. Third option is the carbon halogen bond in haloarenes is longer than the carbon X bond in haloalkanes. Look at this. Nucleophilic substitution reactions are more flexible in the case of haloalkanes but not of the haloarenes. So haloarenes do not show the nucleophilic substitution reactions. So first option is wrong option. Second one is in haloarenes the carbon halogen bond requires partial double bond character. This is the right one. Partial double bond character. This is the partial double bond character. So this option will be the correct one. And coming to the third one, the CX bond in haloarenes is longer than the CX bond in haloalkanes. Look at this. This carbon is of the sp2 carbon, and in the case of CH3CH2X, so this is of the sp3 carbon atom. Sp3 is having the longer bond length than that of the sp2 carbon. So the third option B is the wrong option. Fourth one is in haloarenes the phenyl cation formed as a result of the self ionization is stable. So this is the wrong option. So correct option will be the second one. Haloalkanes, haloarenes, the carbon X bond acquires the partial double bond character. This is the correct option. Next question. The de Broglie's wavelength of a tennis ball of the mass 60 grams moving with a velocity of the 10 meter per second is approximately. Planck's constant is given as h equal to 6.63 into 10 power minus 34 joule second. Any guess? De Broglie's wavelength lambda equal to h by mv. We have to find out the lambda value. H value is given as 6.6 into 10 power minus 34 by mass value is given as 10 meter per second into 60 grams. That will be of the 1.1 into 10 power minus 33. 10 power minus 33 meters. Next question. Match the following. Beckmann's method, Oswald-Spackers method, Berkeley-Hartley method, and Landsberg's method. Here, column 2 is given as osmotic pressure, elevation in boiling point, depression in freezing point, relative lowering of vapor pressure. Correct the match the following. Tell me the answer, Anish. Look at this. For the Beckmann's method, we are using the depression in freezing point. For the Oswald-Spackers method, we are using the relative lowering of vapor pressure. Oswald-Spackers method is for the relative lowering of vapor pressure. And the Berkeley-Hartley method is for the osmotic pressure. And next one is elevation in boiling point. Elevation in boiling point. These are the correct match. Next question. Calamine, bauxite, malachite and siderite respectively the ores of. Calamine, bauxite, malachite and the siderite. Look at this, calamine is the zinc ore. Calamine is the zinc ore and bauxite is the aluminum ore, Al2O3. Malachite is copper ore. Malachite is copper ore and siderite is of the iron carbonate. Siderite is of the iron carbonate ore. So the correct option will be the zinc, aluminium, copper and the iron. Next question. Match the following graphs of a gas with respect to the with their corresponding y and x coordinates. Any guess? Look at this. Here three graphs are given and coordinates are given here. We already know that this will be of the, this graph is for PV versus V and coming to the, this one is for the pressure is inversely proportional to volume P versus V. This is of the P versus V and here it is PV versus V and the, this one is P versus 1 by V. P versus 1 by V that is equal to PV equal to constant. PV equal to constant indicates that this will be a straight line starting from the origin. Next question. The compounds formed when KMnO4 is heated to 513 Kelvin. What are the products obtained here? Varun? Tell me the option. Whenever the KMnO4 is heated to 513 Kelvin, then that will be converts into the K2MnO4. K2MnO4 along with manganese dioxide and water molecule. Next question. Glucose plus that will give you the sucrose. Here look at this, glucose and the fructose will give you the sucrose. So glucose is C6H12O6 plus fructose C6H12O6 that will give you the sucrose here C12H22O11 sucrose. So the correct option is glucose and the fructose will give you the sucrose. Next one. Which of the following relations is true based on the partial pressure and the mole fraction? What is the relationship here? pressure and the mole fraction. Any guess? For which one answer? Reply, Maruti. Partial pressure is given by mole fraction into total pressure. This is the expression for finding of the partial pressure over the mole fraction. Next one. Here, match the following question is given. Leclanché cell, fuel cell, nickel cadmium cell. We already know that nickel cadmium cell is a rechargeable cell. And fuel cell is converts energy combustion into the electrical energy. And Leclanché cell is of the, at the anode, Zn loses the two electrons. That means completely oxidation takes place. Oxidation takes place at the Leclanché cell. Option will be for 1C, 1C, and the second one is, second is A, yes, third one is B. So that is the correct option. Is it clear? Next question, 157th question. Which of the following is true about the sodium chloride? Here molecular mass is given as 58.85 atomic mass units. Formula mass is given as 58.5 atomic mass unit. And the third one is given as formula mass is 5.85 AMU. Look at this. Here given compound is NaCl. Find out the atomic weight. Sodium is 23 and chlorine is of the 35.5. That is equal to 58.5. 58.5 is the formula mass. Formula mass is of the 58.5 atomic mass unit. Whenever you are mentioning about the molecular mass, it will be in terms of the grams, but not of the atomic mass units. Is it clear now? So the correct option will be the formula mass equal to 58.58 atomic mass unit. Next one. What size ring is formed when two carboxylic acids forms a dimeric structure through the intermolecular hydrogen bonding? Any guess? Here two carboxylic acids are given. It is into the dimerization and we have to find out the which type of size ring formed here. Look at this. Here I am taking R OH double bond oxygen. This is the carboxylic group. Here also I am taking this one as R double bond oxygen. Here I am placing OH. So there will be a hydrogen bonding between the two carboxylic groups. Then look at this. I am mentioning the hydrogen bonding in between oxygen and the hydrogen. Now, find how many rings are forming here. Look at this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So here they can form 8 membered size rings. Whenever two carboxylic rings are converts into the dimer through the hydrogen bonding, that hydrogen bonding will be the intermolecular hydrogen bonding. Yes, the correct option is the fourth one. You will get the seat in Andhra University. Maruti. Already you have the reservation, handicap reservation, right? So you will get the seat. Next question. Next 159th question. Last two more questions. Look at this. Dilute sodium hydroxide does not react with which of the following? Generally, here the given elements are boron, aluminium, gallium, and the titanium. Look at this. This boron does not react with the aqueous NaOH, but boron react with the fused NaOH so that it can form borates. So aqueous NaOH means we can say that dilute NaOH. Dilute NaOH does not react with the boron, but this boron reacts with the fused NaOH so that it can form the borates. Last question. Which of the following is a biodegradable polymer of a polyamide class? You are writing the exam in 2021, Kumar. From 12th onwards, the Telugu medium classes will be going to start in the Unacademy for the 8 months complete syllabus coverage. It will be in Telugu. Right, Kumar? Come to the Unacademy. Look at this. Which of the following is a biodegradable polymer of the polyamide class? In this case, the given options are dextrose, nylon 2, nylon 6, and here it is. Nylon 6 PHBB. Syllabus coverage will be done in Telugu medium. Look at this. Dextrose and PHBB is biodegradable polymers. Biodegradable polymer, but those are not of the polyamide class group. Those are not having the polyamide group. Whenever in the case of nylon 2 and the nylon 6 is the biodegradable polymer and they are having the polyamide functional group. Whenever in the case of nylon 6,6, which is having the polyamide group, but this is not the biodegradable polymer. Can we say that this is a non-biodegradable polymer? So the correct option is nylon 2 and nylon 6 is a biodegradable polymer which is having of the polyamide functional group. Yes, I will teach. Today attend the 7 o'clock session, 7 p.m. in the evening, so that I will take the tricks and concepts of noble gases in single shot. Noble gases in single shot, only in the examination point of view. You will do the question in maximum of 20 seconds of time. Definitely attend the session at 7 p.m. in the evening, Unacademy special classes. Search for the profile link Vaishali Kaurumanchi and click the follow link button so that you will get the notifications. Right, Kumar? Yes, definitely you come to the sessions. It will be very useful to all of you. Any doubts regarding this? Okay, catch you in the evening in the Unacademy special classes. Yes. Go to the profile link and click the follow button so that you will get the notifications of all my classes. Thank you and catch you there in the Unacademy classes. Come to the sessions also. Thank you. Subscribe this channel and you will get the notification.